Hello everyone, I am Cheshta and I would be discussing the part 3 of August Current Affairs 2018. I am already done with the part 1 and part 2 of the August Current Affairs. If you haven't watched those videos, do watch those videos as I have covered the current affairs from 11th of August to 31st of August. Apart from this, the current affairs for the previous months, June, July and till August 10 are available in the daily current affairs playlist of on Anuj Jindal channel. You can just visit the channel, subscribe to the channel, press the bell icon and you can visit the daily current affairs playlist to watch the previous current affairs video. Let's start with the part 3 of the video. The first question is, which state government has started Tatkal Seva for property registration across the state? So this is the first time the Tatkal Seva for the property registration has been started. And till now we had the Tatkal Seva for the railways and other platforms, but for the property registration, Punjab has started this Tatkal Seva. The state government or the Punjab government has fixed the sum of rupees 5000. This is the facilitation charge which the people are required to pay if they want an appointment for this Tatkal Seva or Tatkal registration for properties. So Punjab has come up with this initiative of Tatkal Seva for property registration. The next question is, which state government has launched the Kanti Velugu scheme which envisages eye screening and vision test camps for the entire population of this state? So recently, which state has come up with this Kanti Velugu scheme? So Telangana has launched new schemes. The first one is the Raitu Bima and the second one is the Kanti Velugu. Let's talk about this Kanti Velugu scheme. So Kanti Velugu scheme, as it says here, under this scheme the eye screening would be done and the vision test camps for the entire population of the state would be established. The government would be providing these spectacles free. So apart from the eye screening and the vision test camps, the spectacles would be provided to the beneficiaries whosoever requires the spectacle after the eye screening. Next scheme which has been launched by Telangana is the Raitu Bima. Raitu Bima is the Farmers Life Insurance Scheme. One important point to note here is there are various schemes being launched around the Andhra Pradesh and Telangana which are related to Raitu. Raitu means farmer. So first thing after reading the word Raitu which comes to your mind is that Raitu is related to farmer. So Raitu is related to farmer and as Bima is the insurance scheme or related to insurance. So it is the farmer's life insurance scheme and under this scheme every farmer would be provided life insurance cover of rupees 5 lakh. How many farmers would be covered or what is the eligibility criteria for the farmers under this scheme? So total of 28 lakh farmers would be are expected to be covered under this scheme and the age group is between 18 to 59 years. So this is the age group or this is the eligibility criteria for the farmers to get eligible for this Raitu Bima scheme. But this Kanti Velugu scheme is for the entire population of Telangana and not just the particular group. The next question is, what is the family income ceiling for the beneficiaries of Women Welfare Scheme Kanya Shri? First of all, Kanya Shri belongs to which state? Kanya Shri belongs to West Bengal. So this is a scheme launched in the state of West Bengal for the women welfare. So earlier the family income ceiling under this scheme was 1,20,000 rupees. This is the ceiling. But recently West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee has lifted this family income ceiling. So there is no family income ceiling for the women welfare scheme Kanya Shri. So the answer for this question is no limit as the limit has been lifted. As the limit has been lifted for the same, the West Bengal government would be incurring an extra or an additional cost of 200 crores. So covering the entire families of under the women welfare scheme, the additional cost would be 200 crores. Now let's talk about this Kanya Shri scheme. What exactly is this Kanya Shri scheme? So it was launched in the year 2013 to prevent the early marriages of girl children of socio-economically disadvantaged families. So one thing which is important is not all the families would be covered under this scheme. So the socially and economically backward families would be covered under the Kanya Shri scheme. It was launched in the year 2013 and has two components. Now what are the two components? The first component is the annual scholarship of rupees 500 rupees. And another one is the one-time grant of rupees 25,000 rupees. So there are two components. The first one is the annual scholarship, which is for the unmarried girls. Now this is an important point, as annual scholarship of rupees 500 is for unmarried girls, and there is a criteria. So the age limit is 13 to 18 years, and it is for the girls who are studying in the classes 8th to 12th. So this is the criteria for the annual scholarship of rupees 500. Another one is the one-time grant of rupees 25,000 rupees for the girls who have turned 18. So this is still 18 years, and the one-time grant is for the girls who have turned 18 who are enrolled either in the government recognized regular or open school or colleges. So important point to note here is the age limit 13 to 8 years for the annual scholarship and above 18 years for the one-time grant. The next is, when is the International Day of Girl Child observed? So each year on October 11, the International Girls Day or International Day of Girl Child is observed. The important point to note here is, recently Amnesty International India has launched a new campaign, Our Safety, Our Rights. So this is the new campaign which has been launched by the Amnesty International India, Our Safety, Our Rights, which aims to create the awareness among the children to help them understand and identify the sexual abuse. So this is the main agenda of the Our Safety, Our Rights campaign, which has been launched by the Amnesty International India to celebrate the International Day of Girl Child, which is observed each year on October 11. Next question is, FSSAI, which stands for Food Safety and Standards Authority of India. So FSSAI launched the RUCO initiative for collection and conversion of used cooking oil into biodiesel. This is important. So RUCO initiative has been launched to collect and convert the used cooking oil into biodiesel. What does RUCO stand for? So RUCO stands for Repurpose Used Cooking Oil. As per the FSSAI, it has been believed that India has the potential to recover 220 crore liters of used cooking oil for the production of biodiesel by the year 2021. The maximum permissible limit is 25% of total polar compounds. Above the 25% or beyond this limit, the cooking oil is not safe for consumption. Moving on to the next question, what is HELENA? So HELENA is the anti-tank guided missile. It is not the halogen inert gas. It is not the Greek Empress. It is the anti-tank guided missile, and it is the helicopter version. It is the helicopter version of NAG. What is this NAG? So NAG is the anti-tank guided missile. Therefore, it has been named HELENA. Heli from the helicopter and NA from the NAG. So HELENA is the helicopter version of the NAG or the anti-tank guided missile NAG. The next question is, who has been designated as the nodal agency for monitoring the complaints which are being received on the government portal that records the child pornography and sexual violence videos? So who has been designated as the nodal agency? Recently, National Crime Records Bureau, NCRB, has been appointed or has been designated as the nodal agency for the monitoring of these complaints. So NCRB would coordinate the services provided, such as they would use the Facebook, YouTube, WhatsApp, and they would ask these service providers to block the malicious videos and the content. So important point here is, National Crime Records Bureau is the nodal agency for monitoring the complaints. Next question is, choose the incorrect option regarding the new standard operating procedures of refilling of ATM. So recently Home Ministry has specified new standard operating procedures for refilling of ATMs, the automated teller machines, which will come into effect from 8th February 2019. So we need to find the incorrect option regarding the provisions which have been formed by the Home Ministry. The first is, the cash loading of the ATMs will not be done after 9 pm in Naxal hit areas. This is true, as the cash loading would not be done before 9 am and after 4 pm in the Naxal hit areas. The next is cash loading of the ATMs will not be done after 9 p.m. in urban areas. This is also correct, as the cash loading of the ATMs will not be done after 9 p.m. and for the rural areas, it is 6 p.m. So after 6 p.m., no cash loading would be done in the ATMs in the rural areas. The next is private cash handling agencies have also been directed to collect money from the banks during the first of the half of the day. It's again true, as they have been directed to collect the money from the banks during the first half or before 12 noon. Next is no cash van should carry cash more than 5 crore on a single trip. This is again correct, that the no cash van would be allowed to carry cash more than rupees 5 crore on a single trip. Apart from this, the vans used for the transport will also be fitted with the GPS tracking device. So for this question, each and every statement is correct. Thus, the answer is none of these, as no statement is incorrect as per the provisions of the standard operating procedures for refilling of ATMs. Next is, where will be the 2018 Men's Hockey World Cup held? So for the first time, Odisha is organizing this 2018 Men's Hockey World Cup, and it would be the 14th edition of the Hockey World Cup Field Hockey Tournament. And where it is scheduled to be held? So it would be held in the Kalinga Stadium in Bhubaneswar. So the Men's Hockey 2018 World Cup would be held in Odisha in Bhubaneswar. The last question for today is, which of the following report does not form part of the 5 thematic reports on sustainable development in Indian Himalayan region? So recently Niti Aayog has come up with this 5 thematic reports on the sustainable development in the Indian Himalaya region. We need to find out which report does not form part of the 5 thematic reports. First of all, let's look what exactly are there in the 5 thematic reports. The first report talks about the inventory and revival of springs in the Himalayan region, as there is water scarcity or to secure water there. So this is the first theme. The next is the transformative approach to shifting cultivation. I would be telling you what exactly needs to be done under this. So as an action under this thematic reports, they have decided to come up with the spring water management. So for the inventory and revival of spring, they have decided to come up with the spring water management. For this transformating of shifting cultivation, they have decided to launch a mission or a program so that they could shift the cultivation in the northeastern states. The next thematic report is based on the sustainable tourism in the Himalayan region. So what action has been taken or what has been decided under this thematic report? So they have decided to come up with the Himalayan Authority, monitoring authority, which would coordinate with the development of the entire Himalayan region. And again, they would come up with the campaign called Himalaya Calling, which is an awareness to action campaign. The next report is related to the informed decision making. Now, what action has been taken for this informed decision making? So they have decided to link it with the Hindukush Himalaya Monitoring and Assessment Program, and they would set up a central data management agency for Himalayan database. The next or the last thematic report is based on the entrepreneurship or the strengthening of skills. Entrepreneurship and strengthening skill landscape in the Himalayas. Now, what action has been decided for promoting or strengthening the skills and entrepreneurship in the Himalayan region? So, development centers would be established for the skill developments and entrepreneurship in the Himalayan states, along with the consortium of institutions of high learning for the mountain specific research and technology. So these are the 5 thematic reports. The first is based on the revival of springs or related to the water security. Next is the shifting cultivation. Third is the sustainable tourism. Fourth is the informed decision making. And last one is the entrepreneurship skills. Now let's go back to the question and see what exactly are the options given. So strengthening and st- Strengthening skill and entrepreneurship landscape is the correct option. Sustainable tourism is under the 5 thematic reports. Shifting cultivation is again. Deforestation was no such thematic report which has been decided. Last is the water security. So deforestation is not among the 5 thematic reports. Apart from it, there was the informed decision making. So these are the 5 thematic reports which have been launched by the Niti Aayog. This is all for the part 3 of the video. If you like the video, please subscribe to the channel Anuj Jindal. There are no charges for the subscription. There's a bell icon over there. Please press the bell icon. I would emphasize you to press the bell icon as you would not miss any update or any video which is being posted. Do share these videos with your friends and people who are preparing for the government competitive exam, and especially SEBI, because these are very important for the SEBI examination. Apart from this, question could be asked in the IBPS mains as well for the current affairs, and soon we are expecting the RBI assistant notification in the month of October, and the current affairs are even asked in the phase 2 of the RBI assistant. Therefore, these current affairs are very important. We have a YouTube community as well. Do join the YouTube community, and please mention the feedback or any queries if there in the comment section below. We would be more than happy to reply to your queries. Download the Infinity app to attempt the current affairs quiz for free. Thank you so much for watching the video.